I said it last week, and I will say it this week. I have a bad feeling that Pecco is going to turn out to be just like Butterfly Joe's friend. That's exactly what I see, especially with his knee starting to feel weird. So I'm just going to throw that out there right now. So let's talk about this episode. This episode pretty much focused on Pecco versus Kong, and it was a really good episode. I love getting to see these two square off. It was so awesome. I mean, when you get to see Kong's introduction in this episode, when he pops up, you see an up-close personal shot of his eyes. It starts zooming out on his face. It looks so awesome, and especially with the music, the way the music is, gotta love this music. I love Ping Pong's music. It's just, I don't know, something about it just gives you that spirit lift up. I don't know what it is. It's so amazing getting to hear the songs that are played, and it gets you really into the entire series and rhythm of what's going on. When Kong pops up, you just see the freaking outer scope view of him just look badass. So anyways, let's talk about the fight. So this fight right here, Pecco versus Kong, it was really interesting, and obviously Pecco won in the end. It's really upsetting getting to see that Kong's dreams and hopes have been crushed. You know, when we first met Kong, he was a very annoying character. I mean, he was awesome. He was pretty much a talented player from China, and he was badass. But we saw that he had a bad attitude problem, and he thought everybody was terrible, scrubs, and stuff like that. As we see in these past episodes, he's really progressed as a character. I mean, what is so interesting is, now that he's formed a team, he has a team of his own, he's like their coach, their trainer, and he's really getting in depth with these players and trying to help them, you know, progress their talents to where they can be better players at ping pong. And that's the type of character development Kong has had in these episodes, and I love that. He's such a likable character now since the first episode. The first episode, like I said, he was cool, just he was an annoying personality, but this, we really see a really good character underneath, and he actually sacrificed his like goals. Pretty much he realizes he has lost all potential to be able to go back to his homeland to be able to play ping pong with this episode. That entire symbolism with the plane, the way it just disappears, that was beautiful, really beautiful. And I love this series for that, the way it uses symbolism and irony and the way it can just do that. It's amazing. So this episode was awesome. A good episode to really show Pecco's skills as a character and really see how much Kong's progressed. I wonder if Kong will have any more major roles in the series. Will he just be a coach now, or will he completely be booted out of the series? I don't know, but really, I would like to see more Kong. At the very least, hopefully Kong becomes a very good coach, or maybe he has some form of redemption. I'd like to see some redemption for Kong, because he definitely deserves a lot more praise. From what he's at now, his standpoint where he's at now, he's a very good character. So everybody, tell me your thoughts on this episode of Ping Pong. Do you feel like, you know, for instance, the final match is going to be between Pecco and Tsukimoto? Do you feel like that's going to happen? Or do you think it's going to be Tsukimoto and Kazuma? Or do you think it's going to be Kazuma and Pecco? I mean, really, what do you think is going to happen at the end of the final round? Please let me know in the comments below. I love you all so much. Please be safe. Chibi out.